been trying to preach on the husband and wife. Amen. The roles and responsibilities of husbands and wives. Amen. Brother Jacob and Sister Faith about to get married in nine and a half days. Amen. What Miss Faith said when we come in, Brother Jacob said, 9.5 days. In other words, they said, if you ain't there Saturday, amen, April the 8th at 12 o'clock, you will be late. Amen. That's right. Amen. You will be late. No doubt. Amen. They got it counting down to the second. Amen. So 12 o'clock, amen, you better be on time or you'll be late. Amen. Amen. Nobody wants to be late for that. Amen. Especially Jacob and Faith. Amen. Amen. So let's think about that. But we've talked about that. We talked about responsibilities of loving one another, living with one another, being loyal to one another. We talked about being faithful to one another and to God. Amen. That's where it's got to start at. Amen. And we talked about their future together. We've talked about their finances. We've talked about forgiveness. We've talked about forbearing one another. Amen. Forgiving one another. I'm telling you, friend, all that's necessary. Amen. And don't know a whole lot more I can say than what I've already said, amen, in regards to that and that responsibilities of husband and wife, amen. That's a great responsibility, amen. If you are a husband and a wife, amen, you have a great responsibility, amen. Remember we talked about paying the debt that you owe. And to one another, amen. No doubt we owe each other a great debt, amen, to do things that God commands us to do in His Word. But tonight, we want to shift gears, amen, and go toward the children, amen, the parent and child, amen, relationship in our day, amen. No doubt, amen, it's in a grave danger. And hey, I'm telling you, that's right, amen. We'll look at one verse of Scripture, amen. Well, let's look at verse number 1, and we'll go down to verse number 6. And then we'll bring the thought that God has put on our heart. Amen. The Bible said here, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches, and love and favor rather than silver and gold. The rich and poor meet together. The Lord is the maker of them all. Amen. I'm glad that He is. Amen. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. By humility and the fear of the Lord are riches and honor and life. Thorns and snares are in the way of the froward. He that doth keep his soul shall be far from them. Verse 6, where we're going to focus tonight, train up a child in the way he should go. Now, I believe that verse has been penknived out of most churches in our day, amen, and most Christian homes, amen. But he said, train up a child in the way that he should go. There is a way, according to that verse, that a child should go, amen. The way that he should go, not the way that he wants to go, amen. Somebody say amen right there, amen. The Bible said a child left to himself will bring his mother to shame, amen. Train up a child in the way that he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Father in heaven, we thank you tonight for your mercy. God, thank you for your grace, your goodness, God. It's already been a joy to be in the house of God tonight. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for passing by our way, Lord, that day and saving our soul. Lord God, I pray tonight you'd help us to take our responsibilities as parents, Lord God, seriously, Lord God, and know, Lord, that there is some children, Lord God, that you've given us, Lord, that you've lent us for a little while, Lord God, to train up. God, I pray that you'd help us to do that for your glory and your honor, and we'll thank you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I want to say tonight, amen, we want to preach on this thought on introducing your children to Mr. and Mrs. Training Manual. Amen. What about that? Amen. You think about this tonight, what we are seeing in our day and time. Amen. What we are experiencing in our country. Amen. And what we are experiencing in our communities and in our churches today is a direct result of a failure, amen, for parents to train up their children. Amen. That's exactly right. Amen. Can I tell you, most of the time, the problem don't lie on the child. It relies on the parents. Amen. If the parents would do what they're supposed to do, amen, I promise you the children would do what they're supposed to do. That's right. Amen. You think about it in our day and time. Amen. I believe one of the biggest problems in our day is that parents are just too busy. Amen. amen, for their children. That's right, amen. And the ones that are not too busy are just plain too lazy, amen. I want to tell you, friend, we're living in a lazy generation, amen, that does not like to do anything that takes time and effort, amen. And can I tell you, raising children for the glory of God will take both, amen, both time and effort, amen. And can I tell you, you're going to need the help of God to do so, amen. It won't be easy. And yes, I promise you, friend, if you got children tonight, friend, you're going to make mistakes, amen. You ain't going to do everything right. There are going to be times that you miss the mark, amen. There are going to be times, Brother Perry, amen, that you just don't do it the way you should, amen. But praise God, you can learn from that mistake, amen. Repent of it, put it under the blood, amen, and don't make it again, amen. I want to tell you, friend, can I tell you, that'll be easier said than done, but I want you to know, friend, that our children's in a mess, amen, in our day. That's right, amen. You don't believe me, just take out of here and ride down the road a little while and go ride through a few parking lots, look down a few sidewalks, amen, and you'll find that children in today's society has been left to raise themselves, amen. They have no authority in their life. They have nobody watching over them, looking out for them, and that's why there's a lot of shame in our time, amen. That's right, amen. That's why a lot of mamas and daddies is walking around with their heads bowed, amen, and their eyes closed, because their children, amen, have been caught up in things, amen, and we'll point the finger at the child, amen, but the responsibility goes back to the parents, amen. That my friend's just plain too lazy, amen. I want you to know that's right. Now I want you to think about this verse tonight. He said, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Amen. Can I tell you, according to this verse, Brother Perry, there's two things implied here. Amen. Number one, the parent is supposed to train the child, amen, as he grows and comes to a place of maturity in his life. God put that responsibility on you and I that have been saved by the grace of God. You don't even have to be saved, amen, for that verse to apply to you, amen. Train up a child, amen. You know whose responsibility, if you have a child tonight, if you have one under your roof, do you know what that is? That's your responsibility to train them, amen. They don't train themselves, amen. They don't do it their way, amen. They do it the way they're taught, amen. Now think about this. I wrote us a definition down. What does it mean to train, amen? Listen now, I want you to know, friend, it won't be easy, amen. A lot of people's got this idea, I can say it one time and that's all that's got to be done. That ain't going to work, amen. It's not a one time and done. It's a consistent effort, amen. I want to tell you, that's something we lacking in Baptist churches today, amen. It's consistency, amen. I'm talking about just doing it over and over again, amen. Do you know what? We get lazy in that. Look what he said. Train means to teach through patience and instruction, amen, over a period of time, amen. I want to tell you, for those of you that's got children tonight, you know what I'm talking about. When you're training up a child, it's going to take a whole lot of patience, amen. That's right, amen. It's going to take a whole lot of instruction over and over again over a long period of time, amen, for them to get it right, amen. But my friend, it's God gave that to us. Can I go on and say this tonight, amen, just while we in a Baptist church, amen, you can have a King James Bible, amen, under your arm every time you come to church, amen. And you can have a King James Bible in every room of your home, amen. And most of us do. But can I tell you, friend, if that King James Bible, amen, is never opened up, amen, and given some instruction to those children, amen, it ain't doing you or them any good, amen. That's right, amen. We'll shout about having a Bible, amen, but we don't ever want to open it up and teach our children, amen, what the Word of God says, amen. And that's why our children in such a mess in our day, amen. I want to tell you, friend, Brother Keith goes to a lot of different churches on the road out there. He'll tell you, he'll say amen to this. I guarantee you, most churches today don't have a lot of children in them anymore. Children are gone, amen. Listen now, friend, you know what? It ain't the children's fault they're gone, amen. It's the parents' fault they're gone. That's right, amen. I want to tell you, friend, a lot of time in churches, you know what? The children, amen, are no longer there because parents has left them to themselves to make their own choice, amen, to do it their way. You know what? Ever since I got saved by the grace of God, when I come to church, my children come to church, amen. That's right, amen. Now, I want to tell you, now, I'm not talking about those that's got the flu and sick, amen, and running a virus. I'm talking about those that's just left to say, I don't want to go today. I'm not going, amen. I want to tell you what you ought to do, amen, is grow you a little bit of backbone, amen, and stand up to that child a little while and tell them, look, we're going to the house of God, amen. This is the Lord's day. I want you to know that's right, amen. He's talking about training up a child, amen. Bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Instruct them and teach them what thus said the word of God. Amen. Our children are in a mess. Amen. Can I tell you this, Brother Brad? We need to learn to train by example. Amen. Can I tell you this is the earliest way that a child learns? Amen. You know how a child learns, Brother Abner? By example. You know how my children learn how to eat? They watch me eat. Amen. You know that's right. You know what? I remember each one of them sitting down at the table, and that bottle was good for a little while. Amen. But after a little while, amen, they get there and get to looking at them taters. Amen. It wasn't long, amen, that bottle was coming out of that mouth and they was chunking it to the side. Amen. You know what they thought? What daddy's eating looks a whole lot better than this liquid juice I got. Amen. I want a tater. Amen. And you know that's what they done. Amen. Little bit at a time, we begin to break it off. Can I tell you this? Can I go and tell you this? We didn't take a whole potato and shove it in their mouth at one time. Amen. That's right, amen. We took a little piece at a time, Brother Perry, and we'd mash it up real good. I say we, my wife did it most of the time, amen. But you know, she'd a little bit at a time, amen. Just enough so we knew it wouldn't choke them, but it'd get them down, amen. And boy, they wanted more, amen, of what we had. Every time we got there, for long, they were sitting there with a bill bone, and you know what? They was feeding themselves, amen, off of that high chair. I want you to know that's right. It ain't a whole lot different in a Baptist church, amen. I want to tell you, friend, our children have to be taught, and they need to be taught by example. They learn to eat by example. They learn to walk by example. You know what? That child gets to looking around, and he's sitting down there crawling, amen, ain't doing a whole lot. And then he gets to looking, everybody else is standing straight up walking. Everybody else is getting around a whole lot better than he is. And you know what? They begin to observe, amen, and for long, they pulling up on something. And boy, they what the Brother Ty, you know what? They'll let go and begin to wobble around and hit a fall, amen. When they hit a fall, you know what? Here comes daddy and mama to the rescue, amen. We pick them up, try to pet them a little bit and send them on their way again, amen. I want you to know, friend, that's the same principle that applies to the church, amen. These younger people need to see some adults that's saved by the grace of God, and being a Christian is more than just by name only, amen. It's by practice, amen. It's something that's a reality in their life. Hey, see mom and daddy as a child of God, and God is first in their life, and we're going to live for Jesus, amen. And I don't care what everybody else is doing. I don't care how lazy anybody else gets. We just going to do it God's way, amen. That's right, amen. It won't be long. You know what you'll have? You'll have an adult sitting on a pew somewhere that loves Jesus, amen, and walking. I want you to know that's right, amen. I want you to know it. What we need to do is we need to introduce our children to Mr. and Mrs. Training manual, amen. We need to let them know, amen, who is the trainer and who is the trainee. Yes, listen, that's backwards in our day, amen. Can I tell you, in the years that I've been preaching, amen, almost 19 years now, where I've got in the most trouble, amen, by parents is preaching to their children, amen. I mean, you can preach all day long, but as soon as you start talking about little Johnny, amen, you're going to get yourself in a mess. I want to tell you, our children need to be taught, amen, from the word of God. And it'd do us good, amen, instead of every time that a preacher says something about their sin, instead of going home, putting our arm around them and cuddling up to them and acting like it's okay and saying the preacher's just old-fashioned and he's out of date, amen, you'd do yourself good siding with God, amen, and let God be true, amen, and it'll help your child in the long run, amen. That's right, amen. What we got to do is say, you know what? I had taught my kids a long time ago. I'm talking about little bitty things. We got one thing straight, Brother Brad. I'm the trainer and you the trainee.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We ain't doing it your way. We doing it my way. Amen. And you know what? When you start paying the light bill, amen, amen, and the mortgage payment, then you can start doing it your way. But until then, we're going to do it Daddy's way. Amen. And Daddy's going to do best he can to follow God. And we want to train you up in the way you should go. And when he owed you, he didn't say that he wouldn't ever get away from it. You know what? This second part of it, amen. I'm telling you, listen, now, our children, they eat, they observe what we do, Brother Perry. But a lot of time, amen, the second part of this is the influence of childhood training will remain with them throughout their life. It don't mean they won't ever get away from it. It don't mean that they won't ever go their own way. It don't mean that they won't ever err from the way. But I want to tell you what they won't get away from. Those things they was taught as a child in that home. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, they can get out there and sin. They can get neck deep in it. Amen. They can wade around in it. But I guarantee you on the authority of the Word of God, somewhere in the middle of all of it, they are reminded that there is a God in heaven. Amen. And they know what this blessed old book said because mom and daddy took time back at home to train them up. Amen. And introduce them to the God of this Bible. Amen. I want you to ask you a question tonight. Have you ever introduced your children to the God of this Bible? Amen. I want you to know that's where it all starts at. Amen. We're to educate them. We're to evangelize them. That's right. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, we're to evangelize our children. I know that they're saved by the good grace of God. Amen. Now think about this, and we also to have a little effort behind it. Amen. Think about this. In 22:6 of the book of Proverbs, in my opinion, Brother Ty, is one of the least practiced, most quoted verses in all the Bible, amen, when it comes to training children. I mean, we quote that verse, but do we practice that verse? You know what? Most of us that don't practice it, amen, when their children get a little older, they leave home, amen. They leave the church. They don't want anything to do with God. They don't want anything to do with the Bible. They don't want anything to do with a preacher. They don't want anything to do with your God, amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. And the ones that somehow do, it's because not because of what you did, amen. If you didn't take time to train them, amen. It's because the grace of Almighty God intervened in their life, amen. You didn't have nothing to do with it if you didn't take time to train them, amen. But the grace of God comes along, Brother Perry. Hey, I raised up in the house of a drunkard, amen. He didn't know nothing about the Bible. I pray that God saves him, Brother Andrew. But you know what? It was the grace of God that intervened in my life, amen, and introduced me to the God of glory, amen, and saved my wretched soul. I'm telling you, Brother Keith, but you know what? Now that I am saved, amen, and I've been given knowledge of the God of that Bible, amen, I am to train my children that way. I'm to introduce them to the God that saved me. Amen. And you know what? I want to tell you, friend, if we can teach our children, amen, to be successful in business. I'm telling you, we can teach them, amen, to make all the money in the world, have the biggest and nicest homes, have a new car, amen, and do all this thing. But if we fail to introduce them to the God of this Bible, we have failed as a parent. Amen. That's right, amen. What we ought to do is introduce them, amen, to who is the training manual. Amen. And they go, I want to tell you, friend, I'm going to say something else too. Well, I do as I say, not as I do. That don't hold water. Listen, they're going to do what you do. You know that's right, amen. You know what? Tell them to do one thing and they see you do something else all your life. Ain't going to cut it. Amen. Now, son, I want you to obey me, but I'm going to rebel against every authority this side of hell. Amen. I want to tell you that don't work. Amen. What they have to do, if you want to see your children obeying authority, you got to obey authority. Amen. I got to obey authority. If we want to see our children, amen, worship the Lord, we got to worship the Lord. Amen. If we want to see our children saved by the grace of God, we got to be saved by the grace of God. If we want to see our children pray, we got to pray. Amen. If we want to see our children read their Bible, we got to read our Bibles. Amen. That's right tonight. Amen. But you know what, my friend? If we don't do those things, we're going to fail as a parent. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, that ain't something I want to do. Amen. I want to train them up. Amen. Now think about this. I want you to know, friend, we have a lot of preachers in our land. Let me go and say this. Amen. I want to make sure you understand. There are a lot of preachers in our land, and it's running up and down this countryside from church to church, from camp meeting to camp meeting, and they've left their wives and children back at home, and they see them once a month, amen, and once every 2 months, and once every 3 months, and their children going to hell without God, amen, while they're running all over the place, amen, playing cowboy Christianity, amen. That's exactly right, amen. I want to tell you, friend, I ain't got a whole lot of confidence in any man that'll run up and down this road all the time and never take his wife and children with him. Amen. You ought to say amen right there. Amen. I'm telling you that's right. Amen. My biggest ministry, amen, is my wife and children. Amen. They are, amen, first, amen, outside the God of heaven. Amen. And my friend, when you get that right, amen, God will help you in some other areas. Amen. Don't ever forget it. Amen. Them children, amen, is yours. Amen. Now think about this. We think about what is the reason that God gave for training children. Look in Proverbs 22 and verse 15. Why should we train our children? Why does a child have to be trained? He said, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child. Now, not my child. Oh, yeah, God said so. God said, your child and my child, foolishness is bound in their heart. Matters of fact, when I was a child, foolishness was bound in my heart. And you know what? Some of us still ain't got over childhood, amen. Still full of foolishness in the heart, amen. That's right, amen. Think about it, amen. But you think about the reason there is a rebellious nature in children, amen. You know what the Bible said, Brother Perry? They come forth from the womb speaking lies. They'll lie to you every opportunity they get. You don't have to teach them to lie. You don't have to teach them to cuss. You don't have to teach them to steal. Amen. You don't have to teach them to be a rebel. They come straight out of the womb being that way. Amen. That's right. Amen. And you know what God said? I want to give them a training manual. Amen. And if you are father and mother, you are a training manual. Amen. And God said, I want to give your children you, amen, how to train them up, amen, so they don't keep doing that. Oh, my friend. Oh, you think about this, amen. They're also a real devil that wants them. Amen. There is a real devil, amen, that wants your children. You know, listen now, I want to try to help us tonight. He'll deceive them. He'll destroy them. He'll damn their soul to hell, amen. That's right. I'm telling you, he'll try to do all he can, amen. And what that devil needs to see is a saved by the grace of God Christian parent that says, I'm standing in the way. I'm fighting tooth and nail. Devil, you can't have my children. I'm not going to let them go without a fight. I'm going to pray for them. I'm going to practice truth in front of them. I'm going to do all I can to stay in your way. In our day, amen, we've got too many parents that's just giving up. You know what? It's easier to let them go than say anything. Amen. It's easier. We don't want to have to fight. I have never in my life seen so many six-year-olds running the home. Amen. I'm talking about six-year-olds, amen, running the house. You don't believe that? Amen. I've seen it. Amen. I'm talking about, man, I have seen children looking at their parents in church. Amen. Can I go and tell you something else? I've seen children roll their eyes at me while I'm preaching. Amen. I ain't talking about the church down the road. I'm talking about in this church. Amen. Rolling them eyeballs. Amen. Back over in that head. And you know what? It'd be a glad day in your life as a parent if you saw that kind of rebellion. Amen. To put a stop to it. Amen. And let them know, amen, that there is a God in heaven that cares about them enough so that they can hear the preached word of God in hopes of their soul being saved. Amen. Can I go and tell you this? Amen. Listen now. I know that I ain't the only one seen that writing back there on the walls in the bathroom. Amen. But you know what? If you saw that mess, you ought to ask your children they do that. Amen. Oh, no, preacher. What's so big deal? Listen. This is the house of God. Amen. The house of the true and living God. Amen. You ought to respect it. Amen. I never seen the day, amen, the house of God so disrespected. Amen. That's right. Amen. When you come to the house of God, amen, you ought to set up. Amen. And listen to the word of God. Amen. There's people that care about you and want to see you saved and want to see you full of the Spirit of God and get some help in your life. Amen. Oh, yes. Amen. You know what amazes me, friend? How they can sit in front of the television 16 and a half hours and can't sit in the house of God 30 minutes without a nap. Amen. That's right. Amen. Help us out tonight. Amen. You know that's right. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, we need some help for our children. Amen. You know what the sad truth is? If you were to look at the statistics, it'd blow your mind how many children is raised up in an independent Baptist home, comes to the house of God where they preach the King James Bible, and my friend, as soon as they 18, 19 years old, they hit the door, never look back, amen. I'm telling you that's right, amen. And you know what the problem is? Christianity was professed, but it wasn't practiced a whole lot, amen. God help our souls tonight, amen, to get it right, amen, and say, you know what? It don't mean you're going to be perfect, but it does mean, amen, you put forth an effort, amen, to try to walk with God, amen. Try to walk with God, amen. Get them something to look at. You know what? God help us tonight, amen. But when my children leave home, Brother Perry, I do, by the grace of God, hope they, listen now, I hope they're able to look back, amen, and say, if my daddy was a child of God, amen, my daddy was a saved child of God. You know what I want them to know, brother? I want them to know, I want them to look back down the road and say, hey, when they, at my graveside, sister, I want them to say, I don't want them to think he's such a hypocrite. I'm telling you, I want them to know that their daddy was a child of God. He may not be perfect, but he tried to walk with the Lord, amen. That's right. Amen. And you know what that'll do? That'll instill a desire in them to walk with God. Amen. Think about it. Amen. Why should we do that? They need to be some parents just standing in the way. I'm talking about standing in the way. Nope. You tell a child something in our day. Nope. You ever spoke to most children that go to church in our day and they give you that, huh, no? Amen. I'm telling you, when I was growing up, my daddy wasn't even saved and he wouldn't tolerate that garbage, amen. I'm telling you that's right. Yes, sir, no, sir, amen. Have a little respect, amen. When an authority speaks to you and somebody, an adult, speaks to you, have some respect, amen. That's right, amen. Listen now, I know you, first time you hear one of my children not say yes, sir, you'll point it back. And they may not do it every time, but I promise you, friend, it ain't because they ain't been taught, amen. I'm telling you, friend, they are told to respect authority. Amen. And an adult figure, amen. When an adult tells them to do something, amen, they're to do it. Amen. You ever heard it? You don't have to listen to what he says. He ain't your daddy. God help your soul, amen.
Amen.
God help your soul, amen. You don't listen. You can trash the church pews if you want to. He can't tell you not to do that. You can leave your garbage in the floor if you want. Hey, don't worry about it. The sweeper will get it. Who's the sweeper? I don't know, and I don't care. Amen. Listen now. I'm telling us the truth tonight. Amen. We need some parents that'll stand in the way and say, you know what? I'm taking back over my household. Amen. For the glory of God, and I'm going to train my children up for him and his glory. Amen. And when it's all over, you'll be glad you did. Amen. We'll get to that in a little while. Amen. But I'm talking about, amen, you think about what is the reason? Why should we be training our children? Amen. Number one, God commanded us to. Amen. He gave, you know what? Can I go on and go on record and say this? It ain't the church's responsibility to train your children. Amen. It's not the school's responsibility to train your children. Hey, nor teach them by the way. Praise God. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, God gave that responsibility to daddy and mama. Amen. To train up their children. Amen. Listen now, it's not the government's responsibility. Amen. To support your youngins either. Amen. God gave that on you. Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Listen now, the requirement of training children. Why? You know what? The last part of that verse, in verse number 15, look what it said. But the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. Now, you know what he said? He said, train him up the way he should go. And then over here, amen, he said, he shall not depart from it. And in Proverbs 22 and verse number 15, he said, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction drive it far from him. Now, you think about this, amen, the requirement. First thing you need to do as a parent, as a training manual, is exercise some restraint. Right. Some restraint. Say no. Look, learn to say no to your children. Right. Amen. Listen now, in our day we've got children doing what they want to do. I'm telling you, friend, you don't, nobody ever tells them no. No, listen, do it your way, amen. I want to tell you, the end result of that's not going to be good. Amen. Well, listen, if you don't want to go, we ain't going to go. Amen. Listen now, I'm telling you, friend, there's folks that won't come to church because children don't come to church. Come on now, you know I'm telling the truth. I've been around Baptist Church a long time, amen. And I tell you, kids are pretend. Kids are fake it, amen. I want to tell you, friend, get them up, amen. Listen now, they'll wake up every Sunday morning with a headache, amen. Hell, you know what? As soon as church time's over, they playing video games and running around the house. And Monday, they okay, amen. As soon as it's time for school, they belly aching again, amen. I'm telling you, that's right, amen. What we need to do is have some restraint. Can I take you over to 1 Samuel chapter 3? I'll show you a man that didn't have no restraint. Amen. He didn't have no restraint. Amen. We're talking about child training tonight. Amen. Amen. It is a biblical principle. Amen. It is still in the Word of God. You think about this, you'll find in chapter number 3 and verse number 22, I believe it is, the Word of God had to say it this way. He said, now when Eli was very old and heard all that his sons did unto all Israel and how they lay with the women that assembled at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, he said unto them, why do ye such things? For I hear of your evil dealings by all this people. Nay, my sons, for it is no good report that I hear. You make the Lord's people to transgress. I'm telling you, friend, over and over again, I want you to know something. Eli waited too long to train his children, amen. I want you to know, friend, he was very old. He waited too late, amen. Brother Brad, I want you to know something. The character of his sons was already determined before he started trying to train them. Amen. In the first few years is the most important. Amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. You let them get that determination in their heart that we rule the roost. It might be real cute and funny when they're two, but when they get 12, amen, it ain't going to be pretty. Amen. Listen, you let them do it when they're 12, amen, you wait till they get 18. Amen. You let them stand up in your face and back talk you when they're 4 and 5 and 6. You wait till they get 17 and 18, amen. Amen, friend. You ain't seen nothing yet. I have seen a rebellious generation in our day that was raised in the house of God that'll stand flat-footed and look their daddy and mom in their face and down-talk them and degrade them and mock them and ridicule them. I'm telling you, friend, you better get a hold on it while they're young, amen. Amen. He waited too late. Amen. He was weak. Amen. You know what? It's the same thing up today, Brother Perry. You know what they say? I'm afraid I'm going to lose them. You already lost them. Listen, if you won't put a rod on that tail, amen, you've already lost them. Amen. Well, that's too plain for some folk, amen, but it's still truth. Amen. If you won't take it to them, amen, you know what? The whole time... Children today know when they got mom and daddy.
Right. Amen.
They know exactly. I'm telling you, they know exactly. Have you ever been to Walmart? Have you ever been to Walmart? I'm talking about, friend. No. Yes. No. Yes. I ain't leaving until I get it. Come on. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. You know what? After about 30 minutes of hearing that garbage on the other aisle, you think, man, if you ain't going to whoop him, let me. Amen. But I'm telling you, friend, you know what they'll say? Well, if you'll just be quiet for a minute,
come on,
we'll go and get it.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know what they know? Every time we go to Walmart, I'm going to give it to you, amen. And when I leave out of here, I'm going to have what I want, amen. That's right, amen. You know what they're doing? They're training you, amen. That's right, amen. And what you ought to be doing, amen, is taking that. Listen, you know what, brother? You act that way in public, you'll get whipped in public, amen. Hey, Uncle Sam, don't tell me not to whoop them children. You can't whoop your children anymore. Just hide and watch, amen. God gave that right to me, amen. He said, put that rod on them, amen. That's right, amen. Amen. And every now and then, you know what? Just use some restraint. Let your no be no.
Right.
Amen. I mean, no about 3 minutes, amen. Then that no turns to a yes. Amen. I can't understand that. Amen. I'm telling you that's right. But you think about it. He weakened, amen. He began to waver, amen. You think about this, amen. In chapter number 2 and verse 29, look what he said. He said, wherefore kick ye at my sacrifice, which I have commanded in my habitation, and honorest thy sons above me, to make yourselves fat in the chiefest of all the offerings of Israel, my people. You know what God said? He said, you honor your sons above me. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, you know what he said? They had disgraced the house of God. Amen. You know what I find? Some think more of their children's reputation than they do God's reputations.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Yeah. We're going to keep this head out. We ain't going to listen now. I'm telling you, friend, there is a generation that they wouldn't dare. Now, they good at calling out your children's sin. They good at standing flat-footed, amen, and putting your children up. Listen, I'm telling you, friend, I got some children, amen, and I promise you, friend, they've been under the spotlight, amen, and everything's magnified, amen, when they do it, and that's all right, amen. But I want you to know, friend, if you say it's sin in my children's life, it's also sin in your children's life, amen. Amen to God. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, I can't believe he lets his children do that. But you know what? You ain't nothing but a hypocrite if you let yours do it and never say nothing about it. They hear you talking about my kids, amen, and then you ought to talk the same to them, amen. That's right, amen. I'm talking about training your children, amen. He said use some restraint. But oh, Eli, my friend, I want you to notice what I find about them, amen. He withheld, amen. You know what I found out? The reason that most parents won't get on their children is because their life's so full of sin.
Right.
Their life is just neck deep in sin, and they can't say nothing to their children because they're guilty of the same things.
Right.
Amen. Now listen, friend, the principles that he had there, he said in verse 12 of chapter number 2, they were sons of Belial. Meaning they was profane and wicked men without profit, worthless. They were failures. They didn't have no manners. They didn't have no respect. Amen. Amen. Yeah, you know what, bro? I'm just telling you tonight, that's right. Amen. Brother Perry, you ain't going to believe this, but I've had children tell my wife, amen, you don't matter.
Yeah.
Well, she may not to you,
right,
but she does to me and she does to God.
That's right.
Amen. You don't matter. Yeah, well, you take it up with God, amen. I'm telling you that's right. You don't matter, amen. You know, listen, I want you to know tonight, amen, there is a God in heaven, amen, that hears every little idle word you say, amen. And I want you to know something, amen. When them children walk away and they murmuring under their breath, amen, and they cursing under their breath, you better know as soon as they get out of their room, it ain't going to be no longer under the breath, amen. They're going to look straight in your face and begin to curse you. Amen. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, their profession, amen. Can I tell you that the Bible said there in verse number 12, they knew not the Lord, amen. They were sons of the priest. They had head knowledge without an evidence that they had ever been born again, amen. I want to tell you, friend, if anybody knows your children, it's you, amen. And you know what? It's amazing how we fruit inspectors in everybody else's life but our children, amen. We can let our children say, I'm saved by the grace of God, and they are full of lying, amen, and stealing and hatred and bitterness, amen. Would be the best you could do, amen, is evangelize them and try to win them to God.
Amen.
I mean, that profession may make you feel real good about them, amen, but I'm telling you, friend, if the fruits in their lives say they're still a child of the devil, amen, you'd be better off praying that God save their soul instead of putting your arm around them and telling them it's all right, God understands.
Right.
Amen. Y'all all right with that tonight, ain't you? Amen. Can I tell you what? The largest evangelism field in this world is the church, the independent Baptist church. There's a lot of children going to hell from the church pew, amen, because mama and daddy, amen, failed to train them in the way they should go. Think about it. They was raised in the house of God, but daddy was so busy that he let his children go to hell. That's what, then this Bible's got that in there. He was so busy around the house of God that he let his children go to hell. And I want to tell you, there's a lot of folk in our day that's so busy trying to protect their reputation that they'll let their children go to hell.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Think about it. I want you to notice something else, the pretense. They have made a mockery of God to the point that people abhorred the altar of God. You know what? I have seen a lot of that in our day where people just let their children go and people, amen, and make a mockery of it. Now, I want you to get back over there with me where we was at. Amen. We'll find, amen. Can I tell you what, Eli, the biggest thing, Brother Ty, this wasn't sin that was hid from him. It was sin he knew about. I mean, he knew about it. He was aware of it. It's one thing if you don't know about something. But when you know about something, amen, you ought to deal with it. That's right. Amen. Think about it. Think about this tonight. The requirement, amen, is restraint. You know what we ought to restrain them? God, let me go on back up a minute. Some men, amen, man, needs to help their wives out, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Some of you men ought to say amen. If you want your wives, say amen. Some of you men, amen, ought to help your wives out. You leave a wife at home, children back talking to them, amen, and everything else. What you ought to do is take the reins, amen, and put them in their place and whip them, amen, for the glory of God, and let them know, amen, that mama is to say so when I'm not here. Amen. It sure wouldn't make it easier on mama when daddy's gone. But you know what? Restrain their actions. Eli knew about their sin, and he just kept letting it go. Restrain their attitudes. Attitudes, amen. I'm talking about, have you ever seen children in a Baptist church, amen, Brother Jacob, that's got the attitude, ain't nobody going to tell me what to do. Ain't nobody going to tell me nothing, amen. I don't care. My mom and daddy don't tell me. Preacher, you ain't going to tell me. Sunday school teacher ain't going to tell me, amen. Amen. I want to tell you what. One day Jesus will tell you, amen. I guarantee you one day he'll have the last say-so, amen. And you won't be able to raise your voice against him. He'll put you in your place.
Right.
Amen. Now you think about it, them attitudes. What about this? Restrain them associations. Evil communications corrupt good manners. And you know what? It's been said a long time now. You can't run with dogs and not get fleas. Amen. I promise you, friend, and you can't run with the heathen and you can't run with sinners and not start practicing sin. Amen. I want you to know that's right. Amen. You can't carry on with a bunch of people that are rebels. Amen. And it not rub off on you. Amen. Somewhere down the road, it's going to get the best of you. Amen. You know what? He talks about that in Psalms 1. And he also talks about in Proverbs 13 about a companion of fools. Amen. Watch their association. What about this? Amen. Restrain their apparel. That's a forgotten doctrine in our day. But put some clothes on your children. Amen. Amen. Cover their bodies up. Amen. I'm amazed how many Baptists, amen, run around talking about dressing right. Amen. But let their children dress any way they want to. Amen. That's right. I'm telling you, friend, that's right. I want to tell you what, if it's right for mama to cover it up, it's right for daughter to cover it up.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't nothing. Hey, I'm telling you, friend, it is hypocrisy for a woman to walk around in a dress dragging the ground and let her daughter run around in a miniskirt.
Right.
Amen to God. Amen. You know what? We'd be better off. Amen. That's right. Amen. It's one thing to say it, but the believing part of it, amen, is when we practice it. Amen. Restrain their apparel. But what about this? Not only the restraint, but what about the rod? Look what he said in Proverbs 13, verse 24. Proverbs 13, verse 24. He that spareth his rod, look what God said. It's strong language. He that spareth his rod hateth his son. But he that loveth him chasteneth him betimes. Amen. You know what I found out? When they're old enough to do wrong, amen, they're old enough to get spanked. When they're old enough to do wrong, they're old enough to get tore up. Amen. You wait till they're 14, amen, it's too late. I want him to know I love him. Well, then start taking that rod to him.
That's right.
And they'll know very well that you love them, amen. Amen. Kim was talking about today. She was talking about how one of the siblings, amen, one time grabbed her nose and got a whipping, amen. And you know what she said? He never did grab my nose again. I said, you know what? That usually will teach you. That will usually correct the problem, amen. But you know what? If they never are spanked, amen, they're going to keep grabbing the nose, amen.
Amen.
That's right. But I promise you, amen, a good whipping, amen, and a good belting, I promise you, you don't spare that rod, amen, and it'll correct all of that. Amen. Correct every bit of it. Amen. But times, over and over again, early and often.
Right.
Amen. That's right. Don't wait till they done backtalk for 16 hours before you get to them. Listen now. Can I please beg you to do something? Amen. And have yourself under control and have them under control.
That's right.
Amen. If you're not under control, don't expect them to be. They're not going to be under control if you're not under control. Amen. But I want you to talk. Listen, I've seen some parents chase their child around and around in circles, amen, till they slap out of breath and can't give a whipping. Amen. You ever believe that, Brother Perry? I'm telling you, that's a sad state. But have yourself under control. You get over here and put your hands over here, you're finna take a whooping.
That's right.
Amen. And after a little while, you ever seen a spare not for their crying? Amen. What about this? You ain't even touched them and they about dead.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, can you believe I love you, Daddy? I love you, Mama. Well, I love you too, hon. I'm finna show you. You know what? You ever heard this? Listen, it hurts me just as much as it hurts you. Just in different places. That's right, Brother Perry, different places. Amen. I don't like doing that either, but I promise you in the long run, you'll be glad you did. Amen. There's restraint. Amen. There's also the rod. But I want to show you something else. Amen. There is the rod. There is restraint. We think about it. Amen. Restrain them. Give them the rod. What is the results of training your children? Now, look what he says there again in Proverbs 29. In verse 15.
Amen.
Amen. He said, the rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth his mother to shame. You know what? You teaching them and giving them some wisdom. Amen. Now, I want you to follow me with this just a minute. You know what it leads to? It leads to, the hopes of it is a redeemed life. Look what he said in Proverbs 23, verse 13 and 14. Withhold not correction from the child. For if thou beatest him with the rod, he shall not die.
Right.
Although he's acting like he's about dead, he's not about dead.
No.
Amen. He said, thou shalt beat him with the rod and shall deliver his soul from hell. Now, you know what? That's what God said.
Yeah.
You know what? In other words, you teach them to follow your commands.
Yeah.
Amen. And do as what you say do.
Right.
And then the hopes of it, Brother Perry, when the Holy Ghost comes passing by, and says, you're lost and you're dying in your sin and you're going to hell.
Right.
But there's hope. Come to Jesus.
Right.
You'll hope they'll do what he says.
Right.
It's that redeemed life. I've seen a lot of children, amen, who's been saved by the grace of God because mom and daddy practice biblical principles of
right.
training their children.
Yeah.
Raising them up, not letting them get away with everything under the sun. Can I go on and tell you, it ain't always everybody else's fault. It's not always everybody. Sometimes your child and my child does wrong. Amen. It ain't everybody else's children's fault all the time. I want to tell you that mentality carries with them when they get to be an adult. Amen. It's everybody else's fault. He would never do that. Amen. Well, he did it. Amen. And I want to tell you, the quicker you own up to that, the better off he'll be. You think about it, it's a redeemed life. But what about this? It's also a righteous life. Look what he said there again in Proverbs 22:15. Foolishness is bound in the heart of the child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. You know what it does? After a few whippings, amen, do you know what, Brother Jacob? That foolishness just happens to take care of itself. You know what they realize? There's a consequence to my every action. Every action that I take, there's going to be a reaction. Amen. And after that reaction comes from that action a couple times, they realize, amen, this is an action that I don't want to take. Because I know that there's going to be, can I go and tell you, daddy's to be the restrainer in the home. Amen. Restrain. It's a righteous lie. But what about this? There's also behind it a rejoicing parent. Look what he said in Proverbs 23 and verse 15. My son, if thy heart be wise, my heart shall rejoice, even mine. That's what God said. He said, you know what? He said, when it's all said and done, and he says, we see our children do the right thing, you know what? Our heart's going to rejoice. It does my heart good, amen, to see your children doing right.
Amen.
Amen. With a desire to do right.
Right.
With wanting to do right. I want to tell you what, you parents, amen, ought to be proud of these young people coming up here, amen, lifting up their voice like a trumpet, singing for the glory of God, amen, with no reservation, no shame, amen, for the glory of God, amen, with a smile on their face, happy in Jesus, amen. They ain't sitting around pouting, sucking their thumbs, amen, mad because they're at the house of God, amen. You know what? That rejoices my heart when I see them doing that.
Yeah.
Amen. I see these young boys up here and these young girls, they come up here smiling, amen, they full of energy, they full. Amen. Amen. You believe it or not, some of them's full of God.
That's right.
Amen. Some of them full of God, amen. I know some of us super spiritual saints won't own up to that, but there's some children in this church full of God. Slout full of God. All of them ain't devils, amen. Understand that. There's some children in this church try to walk with God. It rejoices my soul, amen. It rejoices my heart, and it ought to rejoice yours, amen. Think about it. A righteous life, a rejoicing parent, Proverbs 29, verse 17. I'm telling you, a rejoicing. Correct thy son. Look. And he shall give thee rest. Yea, he shall give delight unto thy soul. That's what God said. You know what he said, Brother Admiral? Now listen, you let them go. You don't train them. You don't teach them. You know what? They pitch in a fit in the home when they two months old all the way up through they 25 most of the time before they ever leave home, amen. And that's all right, amen, if God's in it, amen. But listen here. But they stay at home all these years, amen, and they've been rebelling and you ain't getting them under control. It ain't going to be long. They're going to be out from under your roof. And you know what? They're no longer acting like that in your home. They're acting like that out in society. Amen. And it's open to everybody. And you may not have got them under control, but you can mark it down. There's an authority out there that will. Amen. Amen. And you'll be getting phone calls from people you don't want to get phone calls from, telling you that your son or your daughter's done this, amen. You'll have your daughter coming in, amen, with child out of wedlock, amen. Listen to me. It's still right to be pure, amen. It's still right to keep yourself to that day, amen. You walk down the aisle and give yourself to your husband, amen. That's right, amen. I'm telling you, friend, mom and daddy, you ought to get your head out of the sand and let them know that that's still right, amen. And you know what, friend, they'll come drag it home. Some bum, amen, that wouldn't work a job for nothing, amen. Done got them all knocked up with a child, amen. Out of wedlock, they'll come dragging back in, and they won't have nobody to support them or that child. It'll be on you, and amen. And you'll walk around with your head down in shame when you could have had a little bit of rest, amen. I want to tell you, friend, it is a joy in your heart, amen, to go home at night and to know my daughter ain't out doing that. I ain't got to worry about who she's with. I ain't got to worry about who he's with. I ain't got to worry about what time they're coming home. I ain't worried about whose car they in. Amen. For the glory of God, I know where they're at. Amen. Listen now. You know what? God said if you'll just do it his way, you can be at home getting some rest. Amen. With a little joy. Listen. Amen. Hearing them over there playing that piano in the living room, singing those melodious songs of Melanie, amen, for the glory of God, is a whole lot better than the telephone ringing. I'm saying you better come up here. We got something to talk about. Amen. That's right. Amen. I'm talking about a rejoicing parent. Amen. If you'll train them up right, amen, I promise you, friend, there'll be a day you able to sit down, amen, and you with some. That don't mean they're going to do everything perfect. But you won't have to worry about those constant, continuous calls, amen, in the wee hours of the night. We found him out here on Skid Row with needle marks in his arm, amen, lying in his own vomit, amen, in a drunken mess, and we had to bring him down here. Listen now, this is reality, amen, and we are foolishly mistaken if we don't believe that our child could wind up that way.
Right. Amen.
Amen. There is great potential for these children in this church. Great potential. You ought to do all you can to encourage them to go with God. Ag them on, amen. Encourage them when they sing for him and his glory. Tell them how good a job they do. Listen, if you don't, somebody one day will. Amen. If you won't give them time, somebody will. Amen. If you won't take no effort to them, amen, and put your hand on them, amen, and put your arms around them and show them that you care for them and love them, somebody will, and they'll do it out of deceit, amen, and they'll take them out there and destroy their lives, and when they got everything they want from them, they'll leave them alone, amen, and they'll come dragging back to you. Amen. Listen, that's a whole lot better just training them up God's way.
Amen.
Saying, you know, listen, brother, preacher, you made any mistakes, man? I heard a man the other day talking about, he said, man, I got a book, amen. He said, I got a page, amen, of the mistakes. And me and my wife looked at each other and said, a page? A page? Man, I mean, I got a book. I mean, we got a three-ring binder. But you know what, Brother Perry? We've learned from some of them things.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And you know what? It's going to surprise some of you, but there's more to learn. I wish I could sit up here and tell you, man, but there's more to learn. There's more going to come our way, amen, that we've never experienced. Amen. Yeah, that's another thing. We ought to preach on that about 30 more minutes to you grandparents. Amen. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, if it was good enough for them children, it's good enough for those grandchildren. Amen to God. Amen. That's right. Amen. Oh, he wouldn't dare do nothing. I mean, golly. I ain't never seen but one kid didn't do that. Gracie, she's my favorite. Amen. I tell you what, she's one of those, amen, little things about this tall, amen, that just walks around and just brings a lot of joy in your life. But even Gracie makes mistakes. Amen. Sister Leanne and Brandon will tell you, I see Brandon taking her out all the time. Amen. You hear that wham back there? You know what that is? That's the daddy that says, you ain't going to get away with it. Amen. 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 And you know what? One day he'll be sitting back at home and they'll be having some rest. Yeah. Amen. And you know what I want? I want some rest tonight. Amen. I want to go home knowing that I laid my head down. My children, amen, have been trained. And I want to try to do it the right way for the glory of God. Amen. And I want to know, amen, you know what, Brother Brad? They're going to make some mistakes, amen. But I promise you, friend, there is something in this Bible that tells me, amen, just do it God's way. Right. You'll be glad you did, amen. You will be glad you did. Can I tell you one more thing before we go? Just bringing them to church is not enough.
Amen.
Just bringing them to church is not enough. Just having a Bible in your hands is not enough. Just having a Bible in your car is not enough. Having a Bible sitting around in your living room is not enough. Well, I want to tell you, there comes a point in time where you have to open it up and you have to actually read it. And when you read it, you have to let, when you get in the Word of God, you got to let the Word of God get in you. And it'll go over to those children. Amen. And you know what God will do? God will bless. Amen. And God will encourage. Amen, in the hearts and the lives of these people. Now listen now. I want you to go on and stand with us tonight. You think about it. Just so everybody don't go out here with their lips dragging. Now, I didn't mean that Grace is my favorite of all the children. Amen. She's just the littlest. Amen. She's the one I had to still spoil because she's little. Amen. But you think about it. Amen. Our children are the most important ministry in our lives. If we fail to get a hold of our children, amen, and train them up, then we're missing the whole mark. They're important. These children, one day, I want to see them, Brother Brad, when they could leave and they don't.
Right.
Amen. I want to see it when they don't have to come to church, but they still come.
Right.
Amen. Amen. That's where the rubber meets the road. I've seen a lot of them grow up in church, amen, and as soon as they get out of Mom and Daddy's house, that's the last church they ever see. Amen. And they'll sit here and say amen and shout, but where rubber meets the road when they move out. And I want you to know, amen, our children are important. Amen. And your children's important to me. I pray for your children. I try to call their name out one by one before God. I ask God to save them. I ask God to fill them with the Spirit. I ask God to separate them. I ask God to let them have a sincere heart towards you, to love you, to live for you, hey, that's right, amen. I want these children, amen, to know that there's somebody in this world that cares for them, amen. And if anybody ought to, their parents ought to, their preacher ought to, and the people around the house of God ought to care about these children. Amen. All right, all hearts and minds clear tonight. It has been a joy to be in the Lord's house.